In this example, I evaluate a Wi-Fi link here. Let's do this. So, a Wi-Fi link. A Wi-Fi link typically operates at 2.4 gigahertz, which relates to 12 centimeter wavelength when we do the calculation here. And we assume we transmit with 100 milliwatts, that's typical. And we have 100 meter distance between transmitter and receiver. So I can draw a little picture here. So we have one antenna here, we have one antenna here, and we transmit here with 100 milliwatts. Oops. And our question is, how much power do I receive? And we assume the gain of our antennas is 1. I did not mention this. Yeah. Both antennas have a gain of 1. And now we know all the numbers and we just have to plug in. P received is P transmit. You go back here. P transmit, G receive, and so on. P transmit, or let's write down the formula once. P transmit, G transmit, G received over lambda times lambda over 4 pi r squared. We just plug in everything. 100 milliwatts is 0.1 watt. G transmit is 1. G receive is 1. And our lambda is 12 centimeters. So this becomes 0.12 meter over 4 pi 100 meter. And the thing squared. This we have to calculate just using a calculator. I opened up my Jupyter console here. I load Pylab so I have all my math functions. So it's 0.1 times 1 times 1. Can make that a bit bigger. Maybe see it better. Okay, so 0.1. Times 0.12 over 4 over pi over r was 100. Hmm? So this, and then the whole thing squared times 2 is square in Python. If we didn't make a mistake here, looking good. Yeah. Evaluate and it's 9.11 10 to the minus 10. So this becomes 0.911 10 to the minus 10 watts, which is 9.1, no, like this. Let's go back. 9.11, thanks. Yeah, so this becomes 0.911 nanowatt. So that's my received power. And that's still enough to have the Wi-Fi link operating. I can convert this to dBm's. Remember, dBm is 10 times log 10. Oops. Just 9.11 10 to the minus 10 watts divided by 1 milliwatt, which is 10 to the minus 3 watts. And then I get P received in dBm, which is, let's calculate it. Times log 10 of 9.11 e to the minus 10 divided by 1 e to the minus 3. That would be this, yeah. And we get minus 60.4 dBm. That's my value in dBm. Great. So let's redo the whole thing in using dB values, and let's calculate the path loss first. Path loss, a path is 20 times log 10 of 4 pi r divided by lambda. All these values I have, and we can maybe move this to the left here now, which is 20 times log 10 and 4 times pi times 100 over 0.12 was my, that was my lambda, and I get 80.4 dB. This is my path loss in dB. Factor so many millions. No? So, and from that we can easily now calculate our P receive. Remember is, oops, hang on a second, I forgot my P transmit in dBm, plus gain transmit in dBi, plus gain receive in dBi, minus my path loss AP. I actually often call later on in satellite communication, I call it LP, no? Loss path or attenuation path, doesn't really matter. So P transmit in dBm is here 100 milliwatts, no? 100 milliwatts in dBm, you can do the math. It's 1 milliwatt is 0 dBm, 10 milliwatts is 10 dBm, 100 milliwatts is 20 dBm. So that's 20 dBm. Okay, let's go back here. So we know our transmit power is 20 dBm. The gain of my transmit antenna in dBi, well, it's 1, no? 1 in dBi is 0. So I can write down here, plus 0 dBm or dBi, plus 0 dBi, minus my 80.4. No? Putting this all together, 80 minus 20 becomes 60.4 dBm, and I get the same result without surprise. So that was our very first link we calculated. Now here's the same calculation nicely written, the same results. Minus 60 dBm. And I forgot the minus here, no? Yeah. Okay. Now, similar example, maybe if you like, you can stop the video now, or let's wait for a second, I explain something. And I want to calculate the Hotbird 5 satellite link with real numbers. I looked at my Wikipedia page, and I also calculated using our Python program. It's 38,670 kilometers away from Bremen. It transmits at 11.5 gigahertz. We have a bandwidth of 33 megahertz, which is not important here. Later on becomes important. And we have an EIRP of 50 dB watts, which is 100 kilowatts. Remember? Oops. This, or EIRP, no? EIRP is P transmit times gain transmit. No? So this is nothing else but P transmit times gain transmit. No? So with these values, you can calculate now our received power, and we do not have the antenna, the antenna size. That's why, yeah, I do it slightly different. Sorry. If you want, you can stop the video and once in a while and do the calculation yourself, because I know, let's calculate the path loss first, no? Path loss is 20 times log of 4 pi r over lambda. And when I calculate that, I get 205.4 dB. So this in absolute number is an extremely big number. No? So it's a 1 and then 20.5 zeros. No? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. No? So it's roughly this factor smaller than before. Now you see how small the value becomes. No? Okay, that's my path loss in dB, and we can now calculate our power flux density on the ground. S. And remember, S is P transmit times gain of the transmit antenna over 4 pi r square. Since we know that, it's EIRP over 4 pi r square. So with this known, we can calculate now the power flux density. Let's do that here, because we can do it, which is PT is 100 kilowatts. No, it's EIRP, no? The EIRP is 100 kilowatts divided by 4 divided by pi divided by r square, and r is 38670 e to the 3, because it's kilometers and it's squared times 2. So this is 5.32 10 to the minus 12. 5.32 10 to the minus 12 is pico, so it's pico watts per meter square. So you have an extremely small power flux density on the ground. And now let's see how much area do we need in order to receive the signal. I do the following, and I made it a bit more complicated than I should. Let's add some margin to it. Maybe we do not get the margin. We get the perfect oriented antenna, so we have some polarization and some pointing loss, and also we have clouds. Let's say we have another margin of 3 dB. 3 dB means factor 2, no? That means our S we actually receive is our S receive is only S half. No? It's only half of the power flux density, which we get ideally. Worst case, we get 2.66 picowatts per meter squared. Because we are not in the center of the beam, we have clouds, we have depointing, and so on. No, that's a typical value that we have to give about 3 dB margin. So, well, and next, we need, and that's something we calculate in the lectures the following weeks, we need, what did I write down here, 1.32 picowatts. In order to be able to demodulate the signal in the noise, we need 1.32 picowatts received. And we calculate this next week or the week after. Well, what does it mean? We know P received is S received times my effective area. That makes my effective area I need for my receiving antenna P received over S received, which is 1.32 picowatts over 2.66 picowatts per square meter. Per square meter means times meter square. So I get an area, which is good. 1.32 over same unit. That's why we can just use 2.66. You get 0.49 square meter. So I need an effective area of 0.49 square meter in order to receive the signal, which is, well, when we made it a parabolic dish, a dish with diameter of 80 centimeters. That's roughly this area. So you see, when you have an antenna with 80 centimeters diameter, you can receive Hotbird 5 nicely. Since I put the margin in there, the actual size of the antenna is about 60 centimeters. Maybe I was too conservative with this number as well. Okay, that's how it works. Here's my complete calculation. The same as I did by hand. Well, I go back here so you see it again. And our next topic would be antenna realizations. However, since we are talking about systems, we are not talking too much about how the antennas are actually built, and we just jump to the next step, which is the noise, something we do in the next lecture. Okay, that's it for today. Thank you for listening and have a nice day.